हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे आई स्वाति वर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट स्कूल ऑफ मेडिकल एंड अलाइड साइंसेज, कलकुटिया यूनिवर्सिटी, शैल बी डिस्कसिंग विद यू अबाउट पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन एंड हाउ द पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन इज परफॉर्म इन डीएनए. सो फर्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट to polymerase chain reaction. That is, what is polymerase chain reaction? So PCR is a rapid and versatile in vitro method for amplifying defined target DNA sequence which is present within the source of DNA. Now this particular technique of PCR was first formulated by Carey Mullis in 1985. Usually the method is designed to permit selective amplification of a specific target DNA sequence within a heterogeneous collection of DNA molecule. So this is your method which will allow the selective amplification of a particular DNA sequence within your heterogeneous collection of DNA molecules, which includes your total genomic DNA or your complex cDNA population. To permit such selective amplification, some prior DNA sequence information from the target sequence is required. So to perform that particular amplification of a specific DNA sequence, what we require? We require some prior information, sequence information from the target sequence. This information is used to design two oligonucleotide primers, that is amplimers, which are specific to the target sequence, and these often about your 15 to 25 nucleotide long. Now after the primers are added to the denatured template DNA, after we had performed the addition of primers to your denatured template DNA, see, first denaturing is important so that we can stop the expression while we are manipulating the information. So after denaturing, first we add the primers. They bind specifically to your complementary DNA sequence, that is cDNA sequence, at the target site. In the presence of a suitably heat stable DNA polymerase or DNA precursors, the 4-deoxynucleoside triphosphates, that is dATP, dCTP, dGTP and dTTP primers, initiate the synthesis of new DNA strands which are complementary to the individual DNA strands of the target DNA segment and will overlap each other. Now your PCR is a technique that takes a specific sequence of DNA of small amount and will amplify it to be used for further testing. So this is basically your in vitro technique. Now if we talk about the purpose principle of PCR, so the principle of PCR is your purpose, condition and components. What is the main purpose for which we are performing the PCR? What are your various conditions that are required and what are your various components that are involved? So the first thing is your purpose. So to amplify a lot of double-stranded DNA molecules, that is fragments, with same, that is identical size and sequence by enzymatic method and cyclic condition. So the purpose is the amplification of our double-stranded DNA molecules. Now what are the various conditions? So the conditions are the denaturation of DNA template, annealing of primers and the extension of DNA molecules. This is the step of your denaturation, that first we denature our DNA. So the process of denaturation occurs at the temperature of around about 92 to 95 degrees Celsius. Double stranded DNA will melt into single stranded DNA. So here you can see that your double stranded DNA is melting into your single stranded DNA. Now comes the step of annealing. So what will happen in case of annealing? First, the temperature that is required is your 50 to 70 degrees Celsius, dependent on the melting temperature of the expected duplets. Now in case of annealing, your primers bind to their complementary sequences. Here you can see that these are your two strands of DNA that we had separated. This is your 5 to 3 and your 3 dash to 5 dash. Now what will happen in case of annealing? Your addition of primers will occur. This is your reverse primer. This is your forward primer. So your primers will bind to your complementary DNA sequence. Now comes the step of extension. So for extension, the temperature that is required is your near about 72 degrees Celsius. Time is your 0.5 to 3 minutes. And in this particular case of extension, your DNA polymerase will bind to the anneal primers. Here you can see that tag. Tag is your DNA polymerase that is bind to your anneal primers and extends DNA at the 3' end of the chain. So it will extend the DNA to the 3' end of the chain. Now these are the products of your extension. After the step of annealing, what we get? We get your 2 DNA. Now what are your various chemical components? So the various chemicals that we required is your magnesium chloride in a concentration of 0.5 to 2.5 millimole, buffer solution of a pH 8.3 to 8.8, then your DNTPS, that is your 20 to 200 micrometer in concentration, your primers 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers in concentration, and your DNA polymerase, that is 1 to 2.5 units, target DNA less than 1 microgram. So these are your various chemical components. Now what are the basic requirements for PCR reaction? The first requirement is that the DNA sequence of target region must be known. We must know our target region in a particular DNA sequence. Then the primers typically are 20 to 30 bases in size. These can be readily produced by means of your commercial companies. Can also be prepared using a DNA synthesizer. Thermostable DNA polymerase like your TAC polymerase, which is not inactivated by heating to 95 degrees Celsius. So we must use your DNA polymerase which is thermostable in nature. So one of the example of this particular thermostable polymerase is your TAC polymerase. Now your DNA thermal cycler, machine which is programmed to carry out your heating and cooling of samples over a number of cycles. Now these are your instruments which we can use to perform your PCR. Now what are the basic three aspects of your polymerase chain reaction? So basic three aspects is your specificity, efficiency and your fidelity. Thank you.